I'll answer the question. You want answers?
I think I'm entitled.
You want answers?
I want the truth!
You can't handle the truth!
Are we ready for the truth? New season, new truth. We're here, another season. Oh yeah, definitely for y'all. Often imitated, never replicated. The truth around the SML. What's up, fellas? Coach Pauly here. This is the truth around the SML. New season, new Madden, new me, new everybody, new teams, right? New divisions. It's going to be an action-packed show. I'm going to try to do something I've never done before in the truth and have two dynamic callers on. You know, I know one's definitely going to be here. The second one's still a question mark. I'm not sure what's going to happen with that, you know, to be honest and truthful with you. So I'm going to go over the show agenda real quick. So we have a caller on, historic SML personality. All of you probably know by now who it is. You know, I'm going to introduce him in a second. Then I'm going to go to my division predictions for Madden 21. So what this means is I'm figuring there's going to be around eight seasons. So I'm going to give you each division, how many times each coach will win the division in that cycle. Some have a couple, some have more than a couple, some have zero. But that's the truth, you know, so I got to give you the truth. And then I'm going to go on the last segment of today's show, since we don't have really any standings to go over. We're going to go water cooler talk for the boys, like usual. But today I'm going to try to bring on a caller, you know, somebody with a lot to say, had a lot of controversy in this last couple days. I'm not going to give it away. And he's going to come on firing, man, you know, but just to get him on is going to be a struggle because he's not very good with technology, I don't think, or this kind of technology. So, you know, we'll see what happens. We'll play it by ear. And I'm also going to end off the show with, you know, I don't hide about facts. I'm going to give you the facts, why I chose the team that I did and what I was thinking. And I'm going to give you the truth, man. I don't hide from anybody or anything. And that's the difference between this show, you know, and all the tickle fests that go on. There's no tickling here, man. I just give you, you know, bare balls, man. Bare balls, no hair on this show. So, without further ado, I'm going to introduce, give him a little intro. He deserves, if anybody that's ever been on this show, man, he deserves a good intro. So I'm going to give him an intro, and then I'm going to welcome him on the show for a couple of questions. You know, a couple of hard-hitting questions, but, you know, a lot of softies. You know, when you have the resume that he does, you can't really attack him. You can't really attack him the way I attack most. So, you know, I'm a respectful personality in certain instances. So without further ado, I'm going to give him a little intro here.
I am the greatest.
Come on with power. Come on with power. Come on with dare. Come on with, come on with, come on with, come on with power.
I
am the greatest.
I am the greatest.
Fuck 'em, I won't never love 'em. I'm well, bitch, you know I've been above 'em.
The greatest.
And yes, it is. You guys guessed it. The greatest of all time in the SML. Biggest SML personality. The heartbeat that keeps the league running. Prime time. What's up, buddy?
What's going on? Glad to be on the show, finally. Thank you to Coach Pauly, and shout out to The Truth. The GOAT has arrived.
Oh, yes, baby. The most electric personality, you know, in the SML. Like I said, you're the heartbeat of the SML. We'll get right into it. You know, I don't like to, as you know, I don't like to look back, but since I didn't get you on the show earlier, going back to last season, how easy was that Super Bowl win? It looked pretty easy over a guy who's not even here anymore Sunday.
Yeah, I feel kind of bad since he's not here to defend himself, but it was, yeah, after I knew kind of what I wanted to do, it was pretty, I wouldn't say easy, but it was an easy day's work. You know, we went in, it was a close game for a while, but we pulled away. You know, like I said, at halftime, it was just making a few plays here and there. That's what we did. Went cover three, covered the seams, covered the slant, and went to Sombardi 16.
And was there any help going in? Like, did you get help certain owners, like the OGs on your side?
Yeah, you saw. Okay, so I'm not really big into watching tape. So yeah. What I do is, you know, I got my OGs. So I'll ask them. I'll send a DM here and there and say, mm-hmm. Hey, what do you know about Sunday, or what do you know about Pauly? And mm-hmm. I'll get a message here and there, and it was all kind of the same thing. Like, hey, watch out for the pass rush, you mm-hmm. know, and you know, he's a solid passer. So that's what I did. I try to cover his pass, and I try getting the ball out quick.
Wow, that was, you know, it was the first game was more entertaining, but that game was more, you know, satisfaction for you, I might think, the way it ended. And you just stepped on his throat and didn't let him breathe, pretty much.
I didn't want to make the same mistake twice, so I learned, obviously, from the first time around.
Yeah, no, obviously. And all right, next question. Do you ever see a rivalry or a game, you know, to be like you and you know, Sunday? Like, will there ever be? Like, looking at the league and the landscape now, like QBs in the AFC, like, who's in the – like, can anybody, you know, make up this drama and build it up again? Like that personality. Yeah. Of, like, I don't see it from the NFC. Like, I see, like, okay, like, there's Dump and there's Meats. Like, is there anybody that can actually, you know, hold your jock strap, you know, and build this game up again?
Yeah, there's – Yeah, in the NFC, if we're talking like a Super Bowl matchup, Meats and Dump are probably the premier guys over there in the NFC. And it'll be interesting to see how Meats plays this cycle. But I think that'll be an interesting game. I think Dump will have to kind of grow personality a little bit more and talk a little more trash. And if he can pull that off and become a polarizing guy, I think that would be an interesting game.
Yeah, no, without a doubt. You know, it's just, you know, after last cycle, man, how many people we had watching that game and just the build up to the game. I even was shaking. I don't know what you guys felt playing in the game, but it was pretty cool to see. You know, I just want something like that to happen again. You know, once you have it once, you want to have it again, you know?
Yeah, it's like a bad drug. So we're looking for that. We're looking for that big rival in the NFC. You know, I don't know if they're there quite yet.
Yeah, I get you. And we got to build somebody up, maybe somebody from the primer, maybe some of these new guys, I'm not sure. So going into the divisions, you know, everything's kind of mixed around now, getting used to where everybody is now. What do you see the strongest division in the SML going over them all in your head?
Probably hands down the AFC West with QB, Dan, and Future. And poor ZZ's just going to get ran over like a semi-truck. That's just the truth. ZZ's probably – it's going to be ugly for him. I don't know if he's going to make it through the cycle. But it's gonna be something else. But I think honestly, Future's the man to watch out in that division. I think he might win a majority of the division titles.
Really? You think so? Even over, you know, QB and Dan, the very measured personalities, and you know, Future kind of at the end of the last cycle kind of fell asleep.
Yeah, he fizzled out a little bit. I think that Future is he's got something to prove. And his team's a little bit younger this year, and I think that they'll grow, especially with that running back. And I'm curious to see how QB and Dan will follow up Madden 20.
Yeah, it's going to be an interesting division. How about, I'm following off that question, how about the weakest division in the SML? This one kind of sticks out to everybody, but let's see if you agree.
Let me think. I'm trying to think off the top of my head. Oh, man. Who do you got?
There's bad one. I mean, I can pick up four kindergartners, you know, down the street, and they can probably give a better. Like, it's bad. It's in the NFC.
NFC. Is it NFC North? I don't know.
Who is it? Dude, NFC North. Come on, man. Dude, when you see my playoff predictions coming up, like, you know, I have Mike with some division wins. Anytime I give Mike division wins, you know there's a problem, you know? We have Figs in there who always promises to be good but disappoints over and over again. Then we have two newbies who, you know, got to get their feet wet a little bit, you know, a little wet behind the ears. So that division is, what do you think?
Yeah. Mike might go better than 7-9. He might just go 9-7.
Well, in that division, you're almost getting, you know, six automatic wins. If you can't get over 9 wins, you know, something's wrong with that, you know?
Yeah.
All right, now, any surprises in the draft? I know we just finished the draft. Any surprises on the whole show itself or anything that happened?
Yeah, obviously, we had a few surprises that caught me off guard. I think that Mike taking the Packers was a little surprising. Mm-hmm. I think, Dan was talking that trash along with you. We're joining the AFC South. Didn't quite happen the way I anticipated. I think Mike FML taking the Packers was an interesting choice. Mm-hmm. Obviously, that AFC West, just how it all shook up. I thought QB Stud was going to have a cakewalk division, mm-hmm. and he didn't. You know, he obviously kind of has a division of doom.
Yeah, no, definitely. Dan definitely had a choice to make. He could have been in your division or QBs, and he obviously picked QBs for a reason because he thinks, you know, he's a lesser threat, obviously.
Yeah, so that'll be a good rivalry to watch, especially now that Dan's completely disrespected QB.
Yeah, no, that'll be a good rivalry future in there. And then my man ZZ, man, I just feel bad. I played him last night, and it was ugly. And he has a great team, though. He can throw 90-yarders, but you got to get some defense in there a little bit. All right, now, so last question. Last question for the GOAT. You know, last question. I know he has a lot of SML appearances to make now on a Super Bowl run. What's left for you to accomplish in the SML, man? Like, you know, Montana, Brady, they're still fighting. They don't have as many as you. Like, what's left for you, man? What do you want to do?
Yeah, what motivates me is episodes of The Truth. just a constant people who say you can or can't do something. You know, obviously luck's gone, mm-hmm. so I got to prove I can do it without luck. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, I have a goal of winning every Sombardi and sweeping a cycle. That's my ultimate goal. And until I get that goal, I'm not going to stop.
Wow. Hey, this might be the cycle for you, man, because your division, you know, is so far. And we do not have a Texans owner, right, yet?
Not yet. Hopefully okay. soon. Not yet, though. Got to carefully choose. But when I say sweep, I mean winning 7 or 8 Sombardis in one cycle.
Wow. What's your record so far?
Four. So four. I got to. My goals are to win all of them this cycle and just have 8 of them coming in the mail.
And I'm gonna say this right now, and this is the truth. I think your biggest competition this cycle is going to be in the AFC Championship, and that is going to be the quote unquote Super Bowl. And that is just my prediction. How I'm seeing it right now.
Yeah, yeah, it's easily, it's probably Dan, QB for future right now. Mm-hmm. Just looking at the AFC standings. Meets learned he doesn't like playing me in the playoffs, so he's going to hope that somebody else can knock me out before facing me.
Yeah, Matt, a couple guys. You know, I know a lot of guys are criticizing me for doing what I did, and I will explain that later. But, you know, there's a couple guys that I think kind of got out of town, you know, AFC South or AFC in general, you know. So yeah. We'll bring that up a little later. But there's a couple guys want to throw rocks at me. But, man, they got out of town really quick to the NFC when they had a choice to be in the AFC. So, you know, I'm gonna yell at them later. But, hey, do you have anything else to say to the league? Any announcements? I know you put on a big announcement today. Anything else you want to get across?
No, man, I'm just excited, you know, for being on The Truth. I'm looking forward to be back on after I win a Sombardi this season, season 34, which kicks off on Sunday. Coach Pauly always just happy to have me on. If you ever want me on to talk some trash or give the truth, I will give it 100%.
Yes.
I'm going 16-0 this year. You can book that.
All right. Hey, Coach Prime, thanks for being on, man. I appreciate the truth from you, as you always give. And hopefully to have you on again on the Champion Show, which is the first show of every season. So without further ado, hey, congratulations, and on to the new one, on to the next one.
Thanks for having me.
All right, bro. Peace out. All right, fellas. Now, the first time the truth will give us divisional, okay, wins on each team. Okay, let's go. Let's roll.
Madden.
Let's see it.
The truth. Madden 21 division predictions.
All right, here we go. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to break this down since we don't have standings. The first thing is, usually average, we go 8 seasons per cycle. I know last cycle we did more because maybe you guys started early or whatnot. I wasn't here in the beginning really. But this one, we average about 8 seasons. So I'm going to do this based on 8 seasons. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go in each division, starting with the AFC East, and giving how many times I expect each coach to win their division. And then I'm going to say, you know, this division is going to have a wild card or not. Okay, so starting with the AFC East, okay, we have Noel, okay? Noel is there. He's tough, you know, without a doubt. He has the Bills. I give him 6 AFC East division titles, okay, this cycle, out of 8. I give 1 to myself, okay, and I give 1 to PJ, all right? And that's, you know, that's 8 right there. So one, I see Noel getting 6, okay, East titles, myself, maybe a lucky one, PJ a lucky one. Sorry, Latin Yank, you know, I'm not sure. Maybe this division will have a wild card, but I'm not sure. You know, it's not the strongest division. You know, we have, it's top heavy with Noel, and it's bottom heavy with myself, Latin, and PJ. So it could go either way, really. Next, okay, the North with Woods, NYT, Terrible Two-Step, and KJ. Okay, out of 8 division titles this cycle, I'm going Woods with 4 division titles. NYT with 3 division titles. I think he's going to be deadly with that team. You know, look what he did with Spin Cycle and kind of using that as much as he did. Look at, now he has Lamar. How's somebody going to stop him in the red zone? We could just run it in every time with him if he wants to. You know, nobody's going to catch him. And his receivers are pretty good. He's going to build up a back pretty much. So I see him with 3. And I see Terrible 2-step with 1 North win, divisional win. And my boy KJ, I'm sorry. 0 wins for KJ. I don't see KJ Lander really getting a division win, or I don't know if he's going to even make the playoffs. You know, I have to tell the truth, even though sometimes it hurts. I love KJ, but I don't think he's going to make the playoffs. He's the first 0 I got of not making the playoffs this cycle. To the AFC South, we got Prime, Madden Bomber, Coop, and somebody to be named later. I say Prime wins the South. I know he's not going to like to hear this. 7 out of 8, okay? 7 out of 8 seasons, Prime wins the South. And then I add Mad Bomber, only because this guy is 24-7, you know, seems Madden, and he's going to sneak one in there for a division title for the South. And Coop, you get to 2nd 0, no chance, you're not winning the South. And making the playoffs is going to be a stretch in the AFC, much like, you know, myself. We're going to be pushing here. I don't know. I don't know if I see any wild card contenders here from the South, you know. It's going to be tough, you know. But this division here, the AFC West, wow, that's all I got to say. I see QB winning the division 4 times. I see Dan winning the division 3 times. Let's see. I see Future winning the division once and another 0. ZZ, I don't see you winning the division or sniffing the playoffs, you know. It's hard love, man, but it's the truth. I'm sorry. I see this division getting the most wild card appearances, obviously. I think there could be you know, Dan and Future could, or even QB could be in playoffs every year with the wild card spots. They could get both the wild card spots, you know, if that is. And again, anything could happen, but this division is probably the best division. Again, you know, like QB's division last year, he was one of the best when BG left. I think this division is superb. And I think Dan, QB, and Future, you know, it's a 3-man horse race here. Okay, on to the NFC East here. Okay, out of 8 seasons, okay, which again, that's what I'm predicting we get in, 8 seasons. I say Grams wins 4 of them. Chris Kells, 2. Rowe, 2, even with those skinny legs. And Blunt Burner, you know, I don't really know if he knows, you know, we're in Madden 21 yet with all that hemp, but I don't see Blunt winning one, a division title. This division could get a wild card spot, depending how Chris Kells comes out, maybe. Next, let's go to oh, man. This is the Pop Wiener division, Pop Warner division of the SML NFC North. This is by far the worst division I have ever seen in Madden, in a league I've played in. So, you know, no disrespect, man, but the truth. Mike, I don't know how I'm doing this. I got to check my blood pressure after I say this. But Mike, I'm giving him 5. 5 wins out of 8 division titles. He's getting 5. He's getting 5. Oh, man, my caller is here, maybe. My caller is ringing in. Let's see if we can get this. Let me see. I'm talking to my caller right now. All right, going back to that. Mike, okay? In the North, 5 wins. We got Figs, my boy Figs. He always says he's going to be good the next season. Is this a season? I don't really know. But I'm going to give him 2 division wins this cycle. 2 division wins in the North. And I don't know anything about these 2 guys. I did some research in the DMs through my disciples today. I'm giving Faz 1 division win. Late in the cycle, I call it. 1 division win. And Hova, sorry, man, I did my research. As of right now, I don't know, you know, I haven't seen you guys play, but I'm giving you the Zippo division wins. Next, to the South, we got my boy Royce. Okay, we got my boy Royce, Lawyer. Oh, man, this is also, you know, a pretty tough division, you know, not going to lie. You know, we got Royce and Lawyer. Those are the 2, I think, that you know, are really dangerous in this division. And then we got Colt 45, and then we got Field Gen. So what I'm doing in this division here, I'm giving Royce 4 division, okay, NFC South division titles. I'm giving Lawyer 2, okay, South titles. I'm giving Field Gen 1 title, just because he's a cop and he's eventually going to beat everybody down with that stick hard enough. And then Colt 45, I'm also going to give him one because he came on last cycle late. And we'll see where he is, but I'm going to go Royce is going to dominate, you know, the division wins. He might even have more, and I think there might even be a wild card spot for either Royce or Lawyer here. You know, this is definitely a wild card spot division, along with AFC West, who's stacked, so they have a couple wild card positions, I think. NFC West, last but not least, we got, again, this is a pretty good division, a pretty strong. I would say this could be second strongest division, depending on Cobra, which I heard he's pretty good, you know, so we'll see. I got Dump, my boy Dump, with four division titles in the West, meets three division titles. Cobra, one division title. Maybe he'll sneak one out. I heard he's pretty good. He beat QB, so we'll see. And Tiny, my boy Zero, Tinny, Titan, Tiny, Zero, man, sorry. He's part of the Zero crew. I do see this division maybe getting a wild card berth. Dump and Meets, those are the two that can get wild cards if they don't win the division. Dump won of the West, man, not because he wanted out of the AFC, but he wanted to step on Meats, man. That's what I heard. I had a conversation with his his agents, and he said he was really going after Meats and wants to make him less than average. So that I can confirm. Dump has a mission in mind. So, that's the way it is. So, hey, that's my division predictions, and I'm sticking to it, man. I'm sticking to it. I want one of you guys to record this show and run it back when we're done with this Madden 21 and see how close I am. You know, because I know I am, without a doubt. So, I'm going to try to get this caller on. First time ever done in the truth. I'm going to try to do it. I don't know. You know, I'm this guy with technology. We'll see if we can bring him on with a couple questions. Let's see if I can find him here. It's going to be tough, without a doubt, man. It's going to be tough. Let's see if I can do it. He's on the truth. Let's see here. All right, let's put the call out. I'm calling him live here. You're getting live caller here on the truth. Let's see if he picks. Let's see if he picks up. It's going to be tough. If he picks up, this will be good. Let's call right now. How do you call this guy? Let's see right there. Trying to call him here. This is first time for everything. All right, here we go. Call. Let's see if I can call him. Let's see. Let's see if we got him on the show here. This is live. This is all happening. Hey, are you there?
What's up, Pauly?
Hey, all right, hold on a second. Hold on. I got an intro for you. Hold on. Don't move. Yo, my man, I got an intro for you before we talk. I got an intro starting now.
Oh, what is the malted liquor? What gets you drunker quicker? What comes in bottles or in cans?
Beer.
Can't get enough of it.
Beer.
How we really love it.
Beer.
Makes me think I'm a man.
Beer.
I could kiss and hug it,
beer.
But I'd rather chuck it.
Beer.
Got my belly out to here.
Beer.
I could not refuse it.
Beer.
I could really use a beer.
Beer,
beer,
beer.
Beer,
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 beer.
I can remember.
Hey, here we go. So, you guys have guessed it. One of the best and most outrageous SML personalities, we have Raider fan, the Raider fan on the line. How you doing, Raider?
I'm good. How are you doing, Pauly?
Good, man. I'm very, very excited to have you on the show. People didn't know who I was bringing on, but I told them, you know, we don't run away from the controversy. We embrace the controversy here on The Truth. So, without further ado, I got a question for you. I know it's that what happened in the draft. Explain what happened during the SML draft and your perspective.
Well, the way I see it, my ranking was incorrect. I did not agree with it. And there were certain owners that if they had taken the Raiders, I would have just dealt with it. ZZ, Meats, Prime, NYT, and Mike FML. Mike FML does so much for Primer. He's a very valuable member of the league. NYT, he's been there a long time. He's one of the reasons the league is as strong as it is. He's like one of the original colonies kind of thing. So I appreciate him being ahead of me. Woods, though he doesn't do a lot of content, he's a good friend of mine, and he's the reason I'm in the league. He's been there a long time, and he's as active as he can be. So if Woods had taken him, I'd have been fine. I think that was it. ZZ, Prime, Meats, Mike FML, and NYT and Woods. If those six guys took the Raiders, I'm fine.
Uh-huh.
But the other guys, and no offense to Noel, no offense to Dump, they hate me for saying this, you know, Lawyer. They should not have been ranked ahead of me in my mind.
Uh-huh. Yeah, no.
Future does do articles,
uh-huh.
But I mean, his position as chat moderator is a joke. I mean, if he does his real life job as badly as he does chat moderator, that's shame.
Hey.
And so when, well, my last thing I'll just say on the matter is, I would never, if I knew who Future's favorite team was and they were there and they were the best team in the league, I'm not taking them. I'm not taking them.
Hey,
now, if his favorite team turns out to be the Raiders, I didn't know. But if they're not, he did not. I treat people the way I want to be treated. And that's just my code as a man. And he, I think his code as a man is, I'm an only child and I get whatever I want.
All right, hey, I agree with you, man. I agree with the rankings are messed up because, hey, you know, you put a lot into it. Your video's hilarious. Your takes are hilarious. I agree a lot with what you say and your views on stuff for the most part. And I do agree. They're messed up, man. I spent like an hour getting ready for the show and some guys just post in chat, you know, one thing a week and they skyrocket. But maybe they can take that into consideration going forward. Now, my next question for you, is there any prior rivalry between you and Future, something that could have caused this, you think?
No. I think the world of Future. We played a game one time, and I could hear, I guess he didn't know, but I could hear him, his mic was on. I could hear him interacting with his little girl, or I could hear him interacting with his wife. I mean, he sounds like an awesome person. They sound like an awesome family. He seems to have all his priorities straight. I think the world of Future. I enjoy reading his articles, mm-hmm. but I believe I make the chat. I give people a reason to want to be in the chat. Now we got a lot of great owners to do that. Now, you know, yeah. I can't hold it. I don't. The only thing I have over Mad Bomber, QB Stud, you, and a few others is just my seniority. But am I the most important owner? Hell no. But I have no problems with Future. But I don't think he's active in the chat. I think if you take me away, there's something missing. I think if you take Future away, it's replaceable.
I get you. Hey, I totally, you know, I agree with you. You know, your presence is definitely going to be felt. And I hope, you know, there can be a mano moment with you and Prime. You know, I know, that, you know, I feel since I've been in the league, to be honest, and giving you the truth, they're kind of cold hearted with owners leave. And, you know, they should have embraced them a little bit more and talk it over. Is there ever a chance that you would come back? What are your plans going forward?
I have no interest in coming. I feel like they told me it'd be like, I feel like when they put those people ahead of me in the ranking, they said, these guys are more valuable to us than you are, Raider. And when Future took the Raiders, I felt like he was saying, you know, I do not consider you, that your feelings do not matter. I do
wow.
not care that the game would be more fun with you. Cause I care about, I want everybody to have fun.
Yep.
When they come to me and say, hey, don't talk about politics in the chat. I respect that. Cause if I'm making the chat a less pleasant experience because of my opinions, then I need to shut the hell up.
Yep.
Because nobody signed up for that. You know what I mean?
I agree.
So he basically said, I don't care if you have a fun season. And he did it for a 98 speed running back. That's good Lord.
Wow. You know, wow. That's shallow, huh?
I mean, if that's what he needed to do, I thought everybody liked me. I like everybody. Future basically said, I do not think a damn thing about you, Raider. So
wow.
I just don't like, I don't want to be around that.
Oh, well, Raider,
I know I'm not mature enough to be quiet.
No, I know. I hear you. And that's why I had you on the show, because you always tell the truth no matter what, you know. So I love people like that. I hope, you know, going forward for my sake and the SML sake, you know, that you reconsider and you sit down when cooler heads prevail, and then maybe we can find a resolution to this problem, because, you know, I'm all about resolutions to problems, man. You know how I do. But, hey, you know, thank you for coming on the show. Is there anything else you want to say, you know, parting words?
Despite my hard feelings towards his future, I still hope he wins the Super Bowl because the Raiders deserve it.
Hey, there you go,
the
man.
Best damn team in the game.
All right, Raider fan. Hey,
I hope Future wins 3 Lombardis.
All right. Hey, that's good. Hey, that's good. Hey, and please think about coming back, man. Please, you know, take a step away, and because there's no other league I've been in. Other words, they don't compare. And please think about coming back because we need you.
I like feeling needed. I love your show, Pauly. I'll still be checking out the SML podcast.
All right, hey Raider, thanks a lot, man. Go drink some, you know, some buds. They're waiting for you.
Yeah, I don't know if you ever knew Trey, but he was a Steelers when the league started last year. I'm at his house right now. He's out there grilling. I'm about to go drink a couple more beers with him.
Nice. Now, I'm gonna miss the video though. I'll tell you that, with the chicks. But oh well, you know, hopefully he'll be back. So hey, have a great day, man. I'll talk to you soon.
Later, Pauly. Have
a
good one.
All right, Raider. You too, man. All right. Hey, we had it. Hey, the first show, first The Truth ever with two historic coaches, and they both pretty much told the truth, man, right? So now it's my time to tell the truth, all right? I had a lot of peons lately, and I'm going to call you peons, you know, Royce, you know, Tiny Titans, maybe QB Stud. He's a little bit less of a peon because he won a championship, but, you know, he still likes to run the mouth. Hey, Pauly, you're pussy. Hey, you didn't take the Texans. Dude, you know, I may look dumb, but I'm not dumb. Maybe I play the part a lot of times, but I have a pretty good, you know, IQ level, I would think, especially when it comes to football. And, you know, I was just playing it to a certain extent all that time. I was, you know, they were on my list. They weren't high on my list just because the personnel doesn't fit my style, you know, and obviously nobody else thought they were good either because they're still available, you know, and I don't know if that's the prime factor. It might be, but let's call it, you know, let's call it a spade here, right? I like to go into a pool when I go swimming. I kind of dip my toe in, get my knee in, get my butt, you know, and all the dingleberry, whatever, the ball going in, right? But I like to go in slow. I don't like to dive in. So that's why this cycle, you know, last cycle was in the NFC. Now I come one step closer to the GOAT, AFC, kind of going slow. And who knows? Maybe next cycle I'll go right in. But I didn't think there was a team there to compete with them. We needed a good defense. Houston's an aging defense. It was last year's Jags. Maybe I think about it, to be honest. But, you know, I think the Finns have a young quarterback. They also have, you know, a good RB with great speed. The defense needs work. You know, and that's my reason I didn't take them. And obviously everybody else thought the same way because they're still available out of 32 teams. So that's what do you want? Pauly to get stuck with, a dud there against one of the greatest of all time? That's not the way I roll. But I'll give a shout out. Hey, Royce, yeah, you really, really stood up, right? You're really not a pee pussy, right? You went from the AFC, get your ass kicked by QB and Prime all cycle long, and now you're limping over, okay, to the NFC. It's kind of obvious what you're trying to do, right? Because the NFC is weak for the most part, okay, for the most part, compared to the AFC. It's not even close. I won't even make the playoffs one time probably this cycle because the AFC is so strong. And Tinny Titans, you too, buddy, all right? You should do less John, okay, and less, you know, trying to, you know, you and ZZ trying to box it out verbally. Let's try to do a little bit more winning because you too saw the wrath of Prime last cycle. And what happened? You weaseled your way out. And you didn't even take your own team, the Titans. What a Titans fan you are. You cowered on your own team. And you knew they were getting clowned. You still cowered. And what did you cower for? To go in the NFC West and still get your ass kicked and be fourth place most likely. Because guess what? Cobra, you're not going to probably beat him too often. He's pretty good, I heard. And the other two guys, you know what their resume is. So did you really win anything by weaseling your way out of, you know, the South? Not really. You can, maybe got worse. The scenario may have got worse for you, Tinny. So next time you guys speak about the truth, make sure you know the truth. That's all I'm going to say. And hey, this show's been long enough. My best show ever. I love you guys. Heart to heart, man to man. That's all it is, you know, on the truth. So without further ado, the truth, I think it's about that time. We are out.